Hi guys, in this video we are going to talk about motion diagrams with changing speed, and I'm going to scroll up a little bit and kind of walk you through this document here. Alright, so this is the reading page. In this one we're looking at when the speed changes in the past. In uniform motion, our last unit, all we looked at was the same speed the whole time. And so we had either short arrows or long arrows or arrows in between. And a couple of times we had it go from being fast to being slow, but the arrows were the same for a period of time. In this unit, we have changing speed. So the first thing that you should write down is the definition of acceleration, which I'm just going to jot down right here. When you have acceleration, that's the technical definition, is it's a change in velocity. Now, velocity is speed with direction, and it doesn't specify if you are speeding up or slowing down, so you have to be careful of that. This could be speeding up or slowing down. So speeding up and slowing down, I forgot the up part, slowing down. Speeding up, slowing down, both of those are considered acceleration. The word deceleration is a word that people use in everyday language, not science, okay? So this first one here, we've got the car that is speeding up, and notice that it has a short arrow, and then that arrow gets a little bit longer each time, okay? Now there's something we're gonna add onto our motion diagrams later that kind of gives us an idea of how the velocity is changing. They're called acceleration arrows, but we're not gonna do that quite yet. I'm gonna show you what they look like though. What I do is I draw an extra little arrow on top that shows how the velocity is changing. And essentially what I'm doing is I'm showing what is being added on, so that velocity is increasing. Now this one here, the second one, we've got our object slowing down, so those arrows are getting shorter and shorter and shorter and shorter, which means that we're subtracting. So when I draw an acceleration arrow, it would be pointing the other way like this, because it's slowing down, okay? Again, you don't have to add acceleration arrows yet, but I did want you to see what those look like. Now, here's an interesting one. We have an ostrich and it's running in the negative direction, but if you notice, since it starts over there, it's getting faster and faster. This is where the motion diagrams get a little bit more complicated. We're going to add a little bit each time. This ostrich is going faster and faster, so that's what our acceleration looks like. And here we have a bicycle. Now, this one's going in the negative direction, but you'll see that its arrows get shorter and shorter and shorter, and so this one is slowing down. So my little acceleration arrows point the other direction because we're subtracting from that. So again, we'll draw the acceleration arrows later. Here's a graph showing what that looks like. And if you could see, well, you can see it here pretty well. You're just showing the change in that position, and notice how it's getting a little further each time. That's how we can see that it's accelerating. So what you're gonna do on this is you're going to read the description and then draw what is happening there. And then here's a motion diagram. Now be careful, because this is similar to one we've seen before, but you're going to just write a story that describes something that might be happening that would follow this motion diagram right there. And then I think that's it. So there's just those four questions there for you to answer. And then you can submit this on Schoology. So thanks for watching, and we'll talk about it when I come back.